Hey, playa, are you someone that wants to be popular, but you're not willing to conform to the bad behaviors that the other kids in your school are? Well, that's exactly what Cuddle Kane asked me when he said, "How do I get popular? By not bullying people and not smoking weed." I know exactly what you're talking about. Sometimes it could feel like doing bad things is what makes you cool, but I'm gonna challenge that narrative right after this.
This is the Josh Speaks, you're watching the Josh Speaks.
For those of you that are new here, my name is Josh, and every single Monday through Friday, I make videos sharing tips, ideas, and stories teaching you how to be your best self. Now, popularity is a tricky thing because sometimes people are willing to do whatever it takes to get there. There's different types of popularity you can aspire to, though. One of them is just being super attractive. The attractive kids just somehow are popular because that's who they are. Another type of popularity is just falling into the right kinds of cliques. When you do that, you tend to meet more kids that are popular within that circle. The third type of popularity are the kids who just break all the rules and have no regard for anyone else but themselves. But it's the fourth type of popularity that I think is the most important, and that's the one you should really aspire to attain. Before I share what that is, I really want to break down the other three types of popularity to show you that, hey, they're not sustainable and they can actually backfire. Becoming popular for a singular merit, whether you're either really attractive or really smart, you're really good at an instrument or really good at playing a sport, whatever it may be, people tend to see you only for that thing, and the rest of you kind of falls to the wayside. It's not their fault if they have a standout feature that makes them desirable, but it can lead to jealousy and insecurity in other people around you, and because of that, they're unwilling to see the person that you are. If you're looking to obtain that level of popularity, it's important to showcase more than one aspect of your personality. For example, if you're really attractive, you may also want to showcase your love for comic books or movies, or your love to draw or dance or anything of that nature. The second level of popularity, which comes from being in a clique, can really provide a sense of security for you. You have people you can turn to, and there's always someone that has your back. However, whenever you draw borders around something to create that clique to make it different from everyone else, you end up excluding people or rejecting them based on them not being just like everyone else in that group. And when you start to enter that territory, you might find yourself in a bit of a rat race where you're chasing things that other people in your group like simply because you want to keep up with them. Sometimes you're going to have to conform or compromise a bit of who you are just to maintain that level of personality. And let's just be honest, then that's not you being you. The third level of popularity, not really caring about what anyone thinks, is a very appealing one, but it has a destructive side to it. For example, you might enjoy the fact that people revere you, that they look at you with a sense of caution, knowing that you're gonna do whatever you want and they just have to kind of stand out of your way. You end up being popular because you're dangerous and reckless and you have a wild side to you, but that wild side can still be your downfall because it means that you're not being mindful of how you interact with others. Smoking weed, being a gangster, bullying other kids, doing all these different things can probably make you cool for a certain group of people, but the long-term strategy is that people are not going to want to be around you because you're not trustworthy, you're not kind, you're not someone they can open up to and share things with. Solely following that level of popularity will lead you straight to a brick wall, and that's not what you want to do. So instead, you want to focus on the fourth level of popularity, which is being a sociable and communicable person. This is where I think most people have a blind spot when it comes to popularity. They don't realize that simply by being a kind and caring person towards other people, by being social and asking them about their day and talking to them and following up with them, and just being someone that's enjoyable to be around can actually make you popular. If you're someone that's fun to talk to, then people are going to want to be around you. So that's exactly what you should aspire to. But even this level of popularity can have its downside. If your plan is to be more social to rise to popularity, then you might end up becoming too much of a people pleaser, and no one likes someone that they can just roll over and doesn't stand up on their own. If you go too deep into this level, you might end up even losing your own personality because you're conforming too much to what other people want. So where is the safest spot to be in this whole equation of being popular? I would say probably in the center. You should definitely showcase the talents that you have. Don't be afraid or ashamed of the idea of putting what you're good at front and center. You should also aim to form your own group or clique of people that you can really connect with. Having a group of friends is a great thing because it's people to bounce ideas off of and people that can correct you when you make mistakes. Having bad boy elements is also not necessarily a bad thing. You don't want to be too agreeable. You want to show people that, hey, you're going to stand up for yourself, you're not going to let people walk all over you, and you're going to speak your truth and your mind when you need to. And being that person that is social and can communicate with other people, can open up to them, share things with them, and learn from them shows that you're well-rounded. And I think when you kind of excel in that well-roundedness, you're able to kind of hit all four quadrants of being popular. Remember though, there is no standard metric for what it actually means to be popular. Overall, you should always aim to be a more well-rounded person, to be able to communicate with people better, to be able to socialize, and to be able to stand on your own two feet. What do you think though? Where do the popular people in your life fall into? Are they popular because of something that they do, or because they're in a clique, or because they're just edgy and badass, or because they're social? Leave your comments down below and we'll talk about it. If there's something you want to talk to me about on a deeper level that you don't really feel comfortable sharing in the comment section, you can always shoot me a DM over on Snapchat or Instagram. I do my best to answer as many messages as I can. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up button. If you're new here, subscribe. And remember, the learning doesn't end here. Check out the videos I have over there on the side where I talk more about popularity and how to understand this whole context of what being popular actually is. I'll catch you guys next time though. As always, love and peace.